My name is Nimsh, and I'm here with Aquablood, and this is the grand final. Out of all the players we invited, only Ostkaka and Pavel are left.
One of these guys is going to be taking home $5,000, the other going to be taking home $3,500, and also one of them is going to be crowned Season 2 champion of the Hearthstone Champions League. So, you know, a lot up for grabs here, not just prize money, but the prestige of winning this event. So, yeah, I think Pavel is going to be hungry for this, but also Ostkaka, just to get another kind of major under his belt since winning the World Championship.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, I really like the fact that the World Champion, the guy who actually went through all those rounds and took it, is again in the final. So Ostkaka is proving, like Fireball last year, he won the World Championship, and then he won many tournaments after that. He ended up in many finals. They are proving that they are worth the title, because getting title once is a great achievement, but then holding it for the whole year and winning other events as well, proving that Hearthstone is not random, it's all about skill, I'm the best in the world, is a great achievement.
Yeah, and Pavel is a player, a very good up-and-comer from Europe and Eastern European scene. You know, one of the youngest pro players in Hearthstone, especially on Europe's side, kind of like our very own Amnesiac. And he's been performing very well in end of 2015, going into 2016 now. And he starts off with a good matchup for himself, Freeze Mage versus the Secret Paladin. However, Ostkaka has a very great start.
Yeah, that's a very good point, because I wonder what was Ostkaka thinking taking a Paladin to start with. Apparently, Pavel did snipe that Paladin with Freeze Mage. He was bold enough to take it. Normally, you would think that maybe he will not take the Freeze Mage for the first match because he will be afraid of the Druid being played by Ostkaka as the first deck to open. But he was bold enough to take that Freeze Mage into Paladin. And let's see. Like, overall, it's a great matchup for Freeze Mage. There are cases where Paladin can actually steal it, but it's what it is. It's just stealing it because this matchup is so right.
And I think Competitive Spirits are a good pickup for Ostkaka there, because right now, what he has on board isn't that threatening. But combine that board with a Competitive Spirit and a Coghammer, or just another hero power, that board starts to become a little bit scary and represents a lot of damage over time. So this might actually force out a Frostnova Doomsayer in the future once this Competitive Spirit pops.
Yeah, maybe like even right now, because you can throw Snova Doomsayer this board, and if that's a Competitive Spirit, it will be absolutely wasted. But on the other hand, like looking at this board is only 5 to 6 damage, which is not a lot. You're at 21 as Pavel, so you feel pretty confident. And this matchup is also good because for like Freeze Mage, like just looking at those minions without Competitive Spirit, they are not dealing that much damage. So sometimes you just do not have to throw your removal cards up in the air because you're like, all right, I'll just take 6 damage next turn. That's fine. I have my ice barriers. I have my heal bot.
But this ain't 6 damage anymore. This is a lot more. This is pretty much double that. Gonna do 12 damage to the face. And now a board of 1/1s becomes incredibly threatening after that Competitive Spirit. And now Ostkaka doesn't have to commit much to the board until Pavel finds an answer to what's down already.
And that's the Frostnova Doomsayer. I wonder if there will be a repentance. Like, Ostkaka is not even playing it, but sometimes you can have those funny situations where there is repentance, Doomsayer just gets 0/1, and you kill it with a weapon.
Yeah, those are feel-bad moments for the Freeze Mage, but I think this is a great opportunity for Ostkaka because he's invested a Frostnova Doomsayer in 1/1s, potentially. That's what they started out as. He had a very good value Competitive Spirit. His spider's going to pop open and leave minions on the board. He'll still have a weapon. It does make this turn a little bit dead, but Pavel doesn't have a Frostnova to follow up.
Yeah, he doesn't have it yet. He does have Antonidas, but he'll probably not be able to play it next turn. So for now, next turn for Pavel doesn't look that great, but he will have an empty board from Ostkaka's perspective. So maybe Antonidas is actually a play for the next turn. Just coin Antonidas, 5/7. All right, almost an empty board.
Yeah, you could coin Antonidas. Quite a risky play, though, if Ostkaka has, say, a Blessing of Kings it gets dealt with.
Actually,
be a little unfortunate.
I'm thinking, like, because there are the spiders, maybe Mad Scientist and a ping might be a bit better.
Or is he going? He's just expended the coin.
All right.
Drops the Antonidas. Says Oskaka, do you have an answer to this? Because if you don't, I'm going to start throwing fireballs.
Well, an answer would be what? Blessing of Kings, for example, right? Because that would be 5, 6, 7, 8, enough to kill him. But then it will still deal 5 damage to Oskaka. And now Oskaka is in a really tough spot. Like, he can just slam Mist his challenger. But Pavel can generate fireballs. At least one fireball.
Yeah, you can throw one fireball. I guess that's the unfortunate situation of this Antonidas right now, is he's only going to generate one extra fireball. But the Antonidas does pose a threat. He does slow down Oskaka a little bit. And that might be what his intention was. Put something down on the board that Oskaka will feel he needs to get rid of, and give him a bit more time to draw into what he needs.
Also, again, the secrets of the Oskaka is playing, he had to play Redemption from hand, I believe, after this Mysterious Challenger. So he has Redemption from hand, Avenge, and Noble Sacrifice that he played before. So this means that one Noble Sacrifice is still in the deck, and Mysterious Challenger was only able to pull one secret.
So he could Fireball the Challenger now, it would get Redemptioned, Avenge would go on one of the spiders, and then he could ping the six one.
Yeah.
And then he could hit... Well, he could even just leave the Noble Sack there. There's no reason for him to attack. He generates that extra fireball again, so he just recycles a fireball, essentially. But this puts him in a really good spot where Antonidas is still a threat, and he still needs to answer it.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. But Antonidas can be answered with just a weapon attack and attack with the spiders. But still, if the weapon connects to Antonidas, that's 5 damage to face. And... even if Antonidas dies, even the damage is not that important. The important part is that then Pavel is not taking damage from Oskaka. He's still comfortable on 15.
He's just slowing him down, and I think that's what Antonidas' main role was being played that turn. Let's see if I can slow Oskaka down a bit, force him to use those minions, use that weapon to clear my Antonidas, protect my health pool, and let me dig deeper into my deck. And so far, Antonidas has done a fantastic job. He's cleared a challenger very cleanly, and he's slowed Oskaka down. So this is opening up a lot of opportunities for Pavel to take this game. He has Alex ready. He has 2 fireballs ready. He only needs a little bit more to find a win.
Yeah, he's still... cannot do much on the next turn, but I guess on the next turn Pavel will be able to play Anti-Healbot and Med Scientist, and he still draws a card. For Oskaka though, what do you just kill Antonidas and then slam Tyrion? Like, you know, this is Freeze Mage, so Tyrion is posing a threat still. Like, it can die to fireball, but then you're getting a weapon. All right, so Oskaka decides that he really needs to get that ice block down and put Pavel low enough to prevent an Alexstrasza being played on 9 with the ice block on.
Pyroblaster hand's a little slow. Probably would have rather the Frostbolt at this point, just to slow Oskaka down. What could he do here? Flame Strike doesn't seem that great. Anti-Healbot heals him for 8, but a Scientist will also heal him for 8 as well through the Ice Barrier. But if the block gets popped, the Scientist is there ready to get another Ice block out, unless Oskaka kills the Scientist first. So... I think maybe just Anti-Healbot into the Scientist at this point, just to get a lot of sustain on your health pool.
Yeah, it should give him enough to be able to, and even attack with Antonidas maybe, to get rid of the... Oh, actually, not really. You probably want to attack into the Noble Sacrifice with the Mad Scientist. So now Oskaka needs to pop the... Is it possible to pop the block with Blessing of Kings? That's 15. He's missing 1 damage. Oh, man.
If he gets a knife juggle off the hero power that hits face, he'll be able to pop the block. But a lot of minions on board is very risky. And, of course, Antonidas is still sitting there as a threat. He does have an opportunity to clear it at this point with just a Divine Shield and the 1-1. But Oskaka has already kind of said that, you know, I need to pop the block at this point. And he looks like he's going to go for this knife.
That knife could have decided the game, but he did miss that. But yeah, oh man. If you pop the block this turn, then Pavel, can he really play Alexstrasza if he gets Ice Barrier? Not really. Like, he'll have to start trading. And if you just pop the block right now and Pavel getting Ice Barrier from the Mad Scientist, it could have just won the game.
Well, there's going to be no ice block now. That's definitely going to be a ice barrier. And Oskaka, not finding that dagger on the face, decides to take this opportunity to clear the Antonidas finally. I've never seen an Antonidas stay on the board so long.
Yeah. And Oskaka still had a chance to take this game. That was amazing. But right now, I think it's mostly over with Alexstrasza being able to reduce Oskaka to 15. Oh, actually, not over yet. Oskaka can pop the block this turn.
Yeah, I think Pavel might have to Flame Strike here.
How much damage?
Flame Strike does get a. Flame Strike gets clears most of the board. The only thing that will stick around will be the Sludge Belcher, right? Because he can
1-2 actually. Oh no, there is the Noble Sacrifice still, right? So.
Oh, that's true. So Tyrion would stick around.
So you ping the Sludge Belcher and then you Flame Strike, and then there is the 1-2, there is the 6-6. So there is 7 damage on the board. If Oskaka gets like Blessing of Kings, you get 11, so you're still good. It's probably better than just slamming Alexstrasza. Because specifically, if you go for Alexstrasza, there's a good chance that the Ice Block will be popped. Like, you can risk it that there is no Blessing of Kings, but Pavel knows better. He makes a read that it's absolutely possible. Especially because of the sequencing from the last turn, I think, that Oskaka showed.
And, of course, like, the kill in Tyrion. Oh, double Blessing of Kings? Oh, really?
Wow.
Wow.
That was a good read by Pavel. But it doesn't, sadly for Oskaka, it doesn't change anything yet, I think. Like, he cannot pop the block this turn. It's 15.
He's just out of range, not far off. And... yeah, but would you go for it at this point? Just kind of go all in? Or maybe just drop one Blessing of Kings on your token?
I think you have to, because it's like... it's not checkmate yet, but Oskaka is just checking the ice block. And he is putting Pavel under pressure all the time to not give him an opportunity to play that Alexstrasza. Unless Pavel finds a Frostbolt. Because for now, he doesn't have the kill yet with just a double Fireball and Pyroblast. He'll need 2 turns. Or something like a second Froze Nova, maybe, to block the attacks, a freeze. But with this, he probably just needs to go... This is hard. Like, if he is in range of Ashbringer, and he's exactly at 5.
Yeah, clearing the Tyrion, well, clearing the board doesn't really do a lot, simply because the Ashbringer is going to pop the block regardless, so a very awkward situation for Pavel. He could go for some card draw, try and find that freeze, like you said, but if you do commit, say, like an Acolyte, it looks like he's going for the double Fireball, which I figured he would go for, but again, his block is still going to be popped.
Yeah, but this gives him actually a chance to just find... something like an Ice Lance, or like whatever. Like, the Ice Block is getting popped for sure, but he has a couple of tools to be able to deal with the hero attack. And 5 health is still a lot. Like, Keeper of Ulduman and a 1-1 guy will not be able to pop the block if there's just a simple Ice Lance. And Pavel will have some draws. So an interesting game. Like, I didn't expect this game to go this way for sure.
It was looking very much in Pavel's favor for a while, but some aggressive plays from Oskaka, put him in the driver's seat for the win here. It's looking very close. Pavel's going to need to find something to keep him around, and he has to defensively Alexstrasza himself. So Antonidas is gone, and both Fireballs. So he's relying on Alex being able to stick around here and do some damage.
There is the Keeper of Ulduman, so... Oskaka will be able to deal with Alexstrasza, or just limit the damage a bit. Maybe he's still going for the dome. How much damage is there? 11. If he goes into the free one with the 1-1, goes for face, and goes for Mysterious Challenger, there is still one more Noble Sacrifice in the deck, I believe. Because he played one before, he actually played the card.
Yeah, I don't mind actually just ignoring his Alex at this point. Just swinging into the face. And again, putting more pressure on Pavel. What can Pavel find that could potentially win the game here? He needs a freeze effect. He needs something like a Frost Nova to just stall stuff, but that Ashbringer is still chipping away at him.
Yeah, but on the other hand, if he actually deals with this board and Ashbringer can swing for one more swing, Paladin might not have the remaining burst. there is the Blessing of Kings is out. If you are able to deal with this board, like freeze it and maybe then remove it. So going for Acolyte and pinging an Acolyte makes sense.
He's going to go for the Loot Hoarder as well. I guess he's going to drop a freeze on these two minions, potentially. He needs to test the secret first. Noble Sack is what we're convinced it is.
Oh, he needs to act fast. This game is still winnable for Pavel, but it seems for now that... Oh, there's an Ice Block.
There's the Ice Block, so that's going to definitely help in the future. Okay, Frostbolt and then Ice Lance, a 6-6.
Oh, wow. He is taking a gamble here, but what can actually buff those minions? Double Blessing of Kings is out. Lothab is really good, but he's like staying in one. And he knows weapon will never attack him.
So he has no fear of a weapon attack, no fear of a True Silver. Consecration.
Juggler, possibly. Consecration would be lethal. Knife, but Consecration is not common in Paladin decks, and I don't think we've seen one from Ostkaka. A second Knife Juggler would be possible, and a knife hitting that 25%.
But Ostkaka didn't have that lucky knife earlier. So again, it's still a big gamble with Knife Juggler to get the win. Yeah, and Pavel...
Think about
represents
the courage,
lethal.
Right? Like, think about the courage from Pavel. Just, I can be at one health. I'm good. Like, you have 9 power on board. I have 10 health. I'm alive.
Lothab's going to make things awkward because he wants to line up the Pyroblast for the win next turn with the minions he has on board. He wants to force trades, but Lothab is probably going to force an Ice Block for next turn.
Which is fine, I think, especially because... Some minions are going to connect to face, and Ice Block is going to be 8. So I think with that... Oh, no Lothab! So that's still not it, but he can just slam Ice Block, go 4 to face. Oh, actually, Lothab can block the Pyroblast for the next turn, and he can still pop the block!
Smart play from Ostkaka there. I wonder if he was thinking about that. So if he has Pyro, he's seen 2 Fireballs, he's seen... I've definitely seen a Frostbolt, definitely seen an Ice Lance. So if Pyro is his only out, he knows he can't be taken out this turn. Again, being left on 1, much like Pavel did the same to Ostkaka. So very smart play from Ostkaka there.
That is crazy good. That is such a great read. He basically knew that Pavel is sitting on that Pyroblast. And now he pops the block, seals the Pyroblast. And Pavel will have to... One block was already popped, right?
Yes, this is the last one.
Yeah, this is the last one. So Pavel needs to top deck something like an Ice Barrier, I think. But it still might be too much power on board after playing Lothab, especially because Ostkaka can deal with those minions. And Pavel is just so upset about this.
Wow. That was a fantastic play from Ostkaka there.
Oh my goodness, he got a Frost Nova, but there is still a weapon, so he cannot do everything he wants. And Ostkaka just brilliantly kept that weapon. Checkmate, well done, indeed.
What an intense game, that was so back and forth. Ostkaka, showing a bit of patience to that Lothab, ultimately won him the game there and takes a 1-0 lead over Pavel. But Pavel's showing that he can go head-to-head with the world champion here. He was very close to winning, so we got an intense series coming up.
Absolutely. I'm so amazed by the play by both of them, and just Pavel staying at one, making the reads, and then Ostkaka giving himself a chance first with the juggle, and then just making perfect plays with using that weapon, pushing when it was important to, not letting Pavel play the Alexstrasza, just checkmating him all the time, and then with that Lothab into Pyroblast. Not playing it where you would think just slamming Lothab on that board to protect the board on one hand and just giving yourself a chance would be an obvious thing to do, but then keeping the Lothab and realizing, oh wow, he just cannot kill him next turn, just pops the block and wins.
Another thing to consider as well is Ostkaka left an Antonidas on board for about 3 turns. He just ignored it.
Yes.
And I mean, Antonidas, usually when that guy comes down, he has a big target on his back and you just want to take him out, but Ostkaka recognized that Antonidas was not as much as a threat. He needed to pop that block as soon as possible, and that made Pavel play kind of like non-spells, like the heal bot. He played the scientist as well, So he didn't get any value out of that Antonidas. And then Oskaka chose the moment which was right for him to clear the Antonidas. So again, excellent play from Oskaka there.
Yeah, I think like I would simply say like this game that we just watched can go down in history. I feel like I really want to feature this game somewhere and show it to people. When someone asks me, can you point me to the really intense game, a really high skill level game where people had a lot of decisions and the decisions mattered on board and they did influence the win, I'll be like, sure, watch the finals of Hearthstone Champions League, Oskaka versus Pavel, Paladin versus Freeze Mage game, and get your mind blown.
That was such a high level match between two very talented players. Both players showed a lot of presence of mind going into that game of what they had to do to win. Oskaka especially, making some very high level decisions in this game. But not only in this game, in his game against Ecop as well. If you guys missed that, you should definitely check that out. Oskaka doing some very, very amazing stuff there. Getting a 3-0 win over Ecop. So Oskaka definitely showing his stuff as the world champion at the moment.
And the best part is, this is just the beginning of the finals. This was the first game, and we have a couple games more after this, so I'm super excited to see what will happen. I really want to see the Zu versus Zu game, actually, because mostly Zu versus Zu can be really intense with minions trading and who gets an advantage on board and when. Very intricate. It can seem weird from one point if there is a snowball from one player, but on this level, if they get similar hands, that would be super intense.
Another thing to consider as well is the two different types of Zu. Oskaka's running the Zu lock that was very popular in the American preliminaries on the weekend, and Pavel's running the more traditional Zu with the Doomguard. So that Zu mirror is going to be a very intricate matchup anyway, because they're two very different styles. And speaking of mirrors, we have the classic Druid mirror.
Yeah, the classic Druid mirror, which a lot of people say is a coin flip, and I believe it is in fact a coin flip. It's just really similar decks, not many differences. The key is to ramp and actually get tempo plays, because the player who starts attacking face and can get that tempo advantage. There was a small Paladin secret for Oskaka, but disappeared for now.
The best Druid mirrors I find are the mirrors where each player doesn't get ramp, and it becomes a very honest game on board. When one player gets the ramp and the other player doesn't, it can very snowball out of control for the player with the ramp. So when these players have to match each other evenly, that's when the game gets more interesting, I find.
Yeah, I do agree with you. But sometimes I've seen games where one player got ramp and the other was forced to make weird plays, and it actually worked for him. By the way, Weblord, most of the time, is useless versus Druid. Most of the cards from the Druid side do not have Battlecry. They do have Choose, which is not affected. So we can see, in Oskaka's hand, only Lotheb is affected by the Weblord.
And it's not going to matter at this point, especially if that Shredder gets an opportunity to clear the Weblord in time for that Lotheb to come down. As for the Shredder, there is a Keeper that could silence or even ping it. So there's a few options there. What do you prefer here, the silence or the ping?
I think you do ping. I know I'm saying it after the fact. Oh, man. Yeah, but I would prefer that specifically, because you hope your opponent gets a 1-1 and you keep your shade overall, and then you're in a better situation there. But Doomsayer...
Let's go back to that Doomsayer. How much of an impact did that have for Oskaka? Like, he just cleared Pavel's board without really doing much. He doesn't have a brilliant follow-up play. He has a Keeper of the Grove. He decides to go for Living Roots. But wow, that was terrible for Pavel. Considering looking at his hand, he doesn't have any minions to follow up right now.
Yeah, it was very unlucky, because Shade of Naxxramas is one of those cards early in the Druid versus Druid that can kill something like Druid of the Claw later in the game. So you really need your Shade to grow as much as possible. Losing it this early is... it's kind of like a backstab.
And a very slow response from Pavel, then drawing another Wrath. So not drawing that minion he wanted to develop. And then Lotheb can get slammed down. You can innovate Keeper of Law? Ancient of Law. And get some cards. But he does keep hold of the innovate just in case he gets the double combo. So yeah, things are looking pretty tough.
Oh man, Pavel was lucky to get that Pilot Shredder. Without that, he will be in real trouble. A preemptive attack on Lotheb is possible here. Yeah, he does that to be able to contest Dlothar with the Shredder. That's a really nice play that a lot of pro players do, and I've seen a lot of other players actually missing.
But Silence Wrath is just a perfect response. Clears that minion right up, and Lofeb is going to stick around for a little bit. Might see a swipe from Pavel, but Ancient of Lore is looking too tempting. And what a clunky hand at the moment.
Yeah, it's quite tough, especially because he is losing on tempo. Even though he was able to clear the board, Oskaka is the one who is going to play the minion now, and then Pavel needs to react. Oskaka can get faster to the Force of Nature Savager as well, because he will be drawing the cards first. So a really tough situation where Pavel is just playing from behind and is overall behind on health and cards.
What do you think has more influence here, the Shredder in the Shade or the Ancient of Lore?
So Shredder in the Shade, yeah, it's probably better. You want to let your Shade grow, and you don't really need cards in hand at the moment.
The Ancient of Lore might actually replenish Pavel's hand here. Maybe he'll find some minions. Does find a Lofer, so that can come down a little bit later. However, there is a response to this Ancient of Lore. Innovate into swipe, a perfect clear up if he wants to, and it looks like he's going to go for it. And now this board is looking very dangerous from Oskaka.
Yeah, it's tough. It's really tough to come back from this. And Druid doesn't have many comeback mechanisms. There is the swipe and Living Roots, or maybe Force of Nature and Living Roots that can help clear this board somehow. But it's still playing from behind. And you know your opponent has Force of Nature. You know your opponent has Druids of the Claw, or even a simple Dr. Boom that can overpower you easily.
Swipe, I think it's going to have to come down with that Living Roots just to clear up the Shade and the Drake. He will leave the 4-3 on board, so it's very close to lethal. However, if Oskaka does play Dr. Boom next turn, Big Game Hunter might be the swing he needs to kind of maybe get back into this game, but I don't think Oskaka is going to go for that.
Yeah.
Okay, he pops a Shredder first.
Seems like he was going for a Doomsayer. Hoped for a second Doomsayer there.
A second Doomsayer? That's very ambitious, Pavel.
Well, you know, he is so behind that he has to make those tough choices. I was trying to get one damage on the Treant. Alright, that's something. He's not dead yet, but pretty soon. And even with the Dr. Boom being sniped by the Big Game Hunter, Skaka doesn't really have to play the Dr. Boom. He might just Ancient of Lore and draw cards.
Ancient of Lore and the Shade seems pretty nice. Plays around Big Game Hunter. Puts two threats down, which Pavel will have to have very specific answers for. Although he could just slam Dr. Boom, like you said, those Boom bots pose enough of a threat on their own. However, I do like the Ancient of Lore here. Just play around that Big Game Hunter and try and secure this win next turn.
And Pavel concedes. He knows there is no coming back from this. There was no way to clear the board. So Oskaka taking the lead 2-0 versus Pavel. He just needs to win with the Zoo deck. But there is a Freeze Mage. Zoo will be good versus Druid, but Druid still has a chance to win versus Zoo if he gets a good hand. Freeze Mage versus Zoo is a great match. And then the last deck for Pavel was Paladin, no, it was a Zoo of his own. Alright, so, well, I don't want to be a Doomsayer here, but Oskar has a really good chance to win this.
Yeah, Oskaka could 3-0. Taking a 6-0 final in the last two games of this tournament, which would be a big testament to his title as world champion. However, Pavel is definitely a player who can take games off Oskaka. I think he showed a very strong performance against Tice as well as against Orange. So I believe Pavel can definitely take this. And with this hand, this is definitely a hand you want to have against Zoo. Early stuff, you got some freeze, you got some card draw, you got some heal. So a bit of everything you need to fight a Zoo player.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the match is not over till it's over, and Pavel still has a chance to take the whole match. A reverse sweep would be even more impressive than just, a head-to-head battle. So Freeze Mage definitely has a good matchup versus Zoo, and I believe Pavel will take this without problems. If Oskaka takes this game, Zoo versus Freeze Mage, that demands even more respect.
Yeah, of course. I mean, this is a bad matchup, but we saw Asukaka win two bad matchups against Ekop. So he has done it in this tournament, and he has done it today. So, you know, I'm pretty convinced he could do it again if he wants to.
And honestly, this version of Zo might be even better versus Prismage. Like, it's still a bad matchup, I feel, but the fact that you're having Sea Giants and... have we seen Enhanced Meccano from Asukaka? I think we had. He still has Gormok, so he might have enough burst and big creatures to actually be problematic for the Freeze Mage on those key turns.
And let's not forget Leeroy.
Yeah, exactly. That's look at his hand. Like, he already has PO Soulfire.
That's a lot of burst damage already. He just needs a Leeroy to back that up. And then his tremendous reach with this deck, something Zoo hasn't had in its history. Being able to do a lot of burst damage from hand outside of, say, a PO on a minion and a Doomguard. So yeah, this is pretty dangerous for Pavel already, but his hand is pretty decent. You know, like I said, he has a bit of everything he needs to stay in this game. But Asukaka has another egg, AoE insurance, you know, those AoE clears, pop up an eggs and leave 4/4s on the board. And you never want to leave 4/4s on the board when you do those clears.
Do you like the second Nerubian Egg or do you like the Life Tap? Because sometimes Nerubian Eggs can be not that useful for you, mostly because it just takes the spot on the board. And if your opponent goes for the freezes, sometimes you just have many minions on board, but you only deal 4 to 6 damage. So Freeze Mage doesn't even need to freeze your board or do anything. He's like, fine, just attack me for those slow numbers or low numbers.
I think it's fine keeping the egg in your hand, because you have an egg out, so if a blizzard does come down next turn, it'll pop the one egg. And like you said, it doesn't take too much space on the board at that point, and once that egg has been popped, you can drop another egg, so it kind of gives you insurance once again. Lofeb to Asukaka's hand is a big card. He can lock out a freeze turn or a flame strike turn, and be able to push even more aggressively of damage, and an owl. So he has two of the key cards that can really put Freeze Mage into a state of misery, because those cards can be devastating in their plans of clearing the board.
Yeah, I think, like, I would easily say that his hand at the moment with all the five cards are really good versus Freeze Mage. All those cards are a threat. Burst, Spell Lock, Silence, and a big dude. That's great.
How do you go about this turn? Forestland is definitely a threat you want to get rid of. However, we've seen Asukaka ignore these kind of invisible taunt minions before. I think Forestland's a bigger threat than Antonidas at this point.
Yeah, probably it is, especially because you will be going lower. I would like seeing a Sea Giant here overall to have a big threat and force a freeze from your opponent that you can actually do something about, and definitely clearing some part of your board to be able to have space on board and play something like Lothab or Arenbeek. And Asukaka does that. He knows he needs the space. If there is a Frost Nova Doomsayer, he needs space for silence.
And this way, he can silence his Sea Giant next turn instead of silencing the Doomsayer, and then he can clear the Doomsayer. So the Doomsayer has no chance of soaking up knives. And those knives could be very important in finding lethal in the future.
I think there is a slight misplay from Pavel. I would like to see a ping on the Imp Gang boss. And, well, it's not like a misplay, but knowing that there is a possible Iron Beak into that Doomsayer, if you ping the Imp Gang boss, you fill out his board and then you Frost Nova. So there is no chance for him to play the Iron Beak to silence the Doomsayer.
Yeah, that's really good, actually. If he had gone for that, this wouldn't be happening right now. And the giant clears up the Doomsayer. Now look at this board. Very threatening. No more Doomsayer, no more freeze. Flamestrike being the only thing that he can drop right now. But it pops open at least one egg, which is very dangerous.
I think that's still fine. You have the Frostbolt, so you can... You will end up with a 4/4 on board and an 8/1 if you Frostbolt it.
Yeah, the Frostbolt's great, actually. Looking at it, he can pop up in the egg here, and then he can Flamestrike, Frostbolt the giant, so next turn he can ping it. He does have to deal with a 4/4, but I wouldn't feel too bad at that point. Goes for the Healbot. Okay, maybe he wants to pop up an egg first before Wait, if you go to the... Can you even go for the heal bot at this point? If you freeze the giant, you do slow things down quite a lot, though.
How much damage is there? 6, 9 damage. So that's not much. Basically, the eggs... Like, not popping the eggs is fine as well. Basically, they are zero attack almost. 10 damage, I think, with the other egg. So Skaka doesn't have enough, and he cannot play any minions here unless he trades, which he can do.
You can pop your egg open to get that 4-4 down. Run your Argus into the anti-heal bot, or even your owl, whichever, and then drop low feb, and then he can't do an AoE effect like a Frost Nova or a Flame Strike, and things look really dangerous from that point.
Yeah, it's hard to clear because of Lothab, and overall I think Oskaka can set up a really nice situation here with that Lothab, and he still has burst. Like, if he pops the block next turn, then Pavel will have to either kill him or freeze the board, and I don't know what to do, block the spells, because there might be a Soulfire just waiting to win the game.
Is he gonna hold off at this point? Interesting. Demanded an answer at this point. He could have dropped a low feb to protect it from the AoE. Perhaps he feels a bit more secure having that egg down as well. What do you think of that play from Oskaka?
I'm already thinking about Pavel's play, actually. With this, he is forcing AoE, and something can stay on board, and then if there's Lothab, he still has Sunburst. Like, he can deal 12 with the Power of Warming so far. It's hard to say. I don't know what exactly Oskaka was thinking there. I'm trying to find a way to win for Pavel. If he can maybe go Antonidas into Ice Block, into Frost Bolts, getting 2 Fireballs, is that enough? No, not really.
He was hovering over Blizzard there. If he goes for the Blizzard, he will leave the egg up. But he can go for the Frostbolt first. He will take a dagger to the face. He can Blizzard, and then he can Flame Strike. However, we know that there's a low feb sat in the hand, so if the Blizzard might just make the Flame Strike... Oh, he goes for the Flame Strike instead, of course, yeah. So this is very clean. He only leaves 1-1-1 up. I forgot that I was a discounted at that point.
Yeah, he had enough mana. And Iceblock, obviously he couldn't play Iceblock this turn as well, because he has an Iceblock already. Okay, so Pavel was able to clear the board. He still has a lot of freezes to stop Oskaka, unless Lothab is played somewhere along the way. And he has an Archmage Antonidas to find... Actually, Blizzard with Doomsayer might be quite good. Freeze the board and stop anything from being played by Oskaka. And now he finds a spell that he can turn into Fireball.
Yeah, I quite like that. Blizzard into Doomsayer. Because low feb doesn't have any effect, really, unless he can clear the Doomsayer as well, which he won't be able to do. He can, well, he'll get an extra imp, right? But that imp gets frozen, of course. So, yeah, he won't be able to use Overwhelming with the Direwolf Alpha, for example. Leeroy comes to hand. That is a way to deal with that Doomsayer with Direwolf Leeroy. Yeah, he really wants to go that line.
He can also pop the block here. Which is quite awkward. I mean, still, Pavel has a block in his hand, like a second one. But is it tempting to pop the block, or do you want to just clear the Doomsayer and keep the board intact?
It is a tough one. I mean, we've seen a lot of AoE clear from Pavel already. So to expect another Blizzard after seeing a Flamestrike Blizzard, Frost Nova, double Doomsayer... He may just take a risk here. I like popping... No, I like clearing, actually, thinking about it. Just keep the board intact, force him to have another answer. He does have the answer to it, unfortunately for Oskaka. But there was a possibility he didn't have it, and then this board would become very threatening.
Yeah, it was a good move overall, because even if you pop the block, you actually have nothing to follow up and kill Pavel. And if he has a second ice block with something like Antonidas, you're in a bad shape. So he was able to stall there, and he's still in the game and fighting. Pavel is getting lower and lower, you know. Implosion didn't hit, but Skaka still has those burst cards in hand.
The only issue as well is Oskaka's getting low as well, so that could be problematic. Alex Straza can be used as a defensive play in the future for Pavel. Here, things are a little bit awkward. Do you fireball the Lofab?
I think what you can do, you can ignore it maybe. Like, you have to consider going for face as well. You've seen Lofab, so what can Zul do after this? Maybe just go Arcane Intellect and attack face, ping face. Get him to 14. Oh, he goes with the fireball to face. That's fine as well. Because next turn, in theory, you will be able to Archmage, Ice Block. Yeah, just Archmage, Ice Block, Ice Lance. And you're good. You have two fireballs. What can he do?
You can also Intellect as well to find that Pyroblast. So you can have three draws to Pyroblast, and then if the block does get popped and he finds a Pyroblast, he just plays another block and then he's won the game. So yeah, I think that's a good play actually. Putting him in range of Pyroblast, putting him in range of potential lethal with all the draws he has coming up.
Yeah. Alright, so it seems like Pablo won this, even though Skaka gave us some excitement. This is a bad matchup to begin with, right? But it seemed like he has an opening somewhere. He had the chance. Like, maybe if you would play Lothar before, or if there would not be the second Blizzard.
Yeah, it was a tough match to navigate. Like you said, it was already pretty bad to start with. But then it's also finding the right way to do things. Playing what can you play around? Can you play around all of the clears in the mage deck, like banking them on drawing them all? But Antonidas gonna come down with the ice block, gonna give him that fireball, frozen ice lance at the Dr. Boon to protect the Antonidas, putting two fireballs in hand, and this should be it now.
Yeah, this should be enough. No second Lothab, Kazan Mystic can save him, Power of Whirlming. Oh wow, Power of Whirlming. Can Power of Whirlming save him at this end of the turn? So the bomb can not kill him. Alright. I was just thinking there's... He doesn't know if it's an ice block, but he knows... Oh, actually... Wait, was there a way... No, there was no way. Okay. The bomb actually like hits by the end of turn of Skaka. So I was thinking there's a way to kill him with the bomb on his turn. But not really.
Now, the wording on the card says end of turn. If you died at the start of your opponent's turn, then there was definitely potential there. But, you know, Skaka shouldn't feel too bad. He did play that match quite well, I think. He did give Pavel a run for his money, considering that's a bad matchup. But he still has to win with two other decks. I mean, the Zulok can still find a win. So we're going into game number four here. 2-1 to Skaka so far. One game away from winning $5,000 and being crowned your champion. But Pavel has... not giving up just yet. He's going to be fighting.
Yeah, absolutely. Pavel got that win that he expected, and now he's going for a mirror match. But I think Skaka has an advantage with regards to decks. You've mentioned that before. Skaka is running the Sea Giant, the Leeroy version, and Pavel is running a more stable, let's say, or standard Dark Iron Dwarf and Brand version. So obviously, openings are openings, but in the grand scheme of things, if there is an early Sea Giant, then there might be not an answer for him from Pavel's perspective. And if both get low on health, then Skaka can actually get an opportunity to Leeroy for the win. But on the other hand, Pavel will be having a stable board. And if he keeps that board stable and extends it, does good trades, and takes Goldshire Footman.
The good old Goldshire Footman. Ready for action, right?
Yeah. Sometimes it's a good card, actually. It's Zoo versus Zoo, but what is on the board? On board, there's a 2-1, right, from Skaka?
Yeah, there's a Abusive Sergeant. Yeah, Goldshire Footman seems like the card. He can defend against a 2-1. Well, in the future, it may not be as effective. It might block a couple of imps, but overall, Knife Juggler is going to be a nice minion to come down. 3-2 with the Knife Juggler effects. Egg's a good way to challenge it in the future, especially with that Power Overwhelming sitting in the background. Is he going to pop the Egg open?
Yeah, wow. Because the Power Overwhelming would give him too much value. And if the Knife hits the 4-4, then Knife Juggler contests it. So a really, already an interesting play, and a great play by Skaka. And he had still a chance like to get something like a Soulfire and then just kill it right away.
And this Knife Juggler poses quite a big threat, so I'd be surprised if we don't see the 4-3 go into it. He could have potentially ignored it there, maybe, because the knives don't interact with the Imp Gang boss, but is that a minion you ever want to leave up?
Probably not. And now Skaka needs to... Oh, actually, he can slam Gormok as a 4-4. And because he is a bit ahead on board at the moment, just keep that initiative. Decides to go for Haunted Creeper. Gormok still presents a big threat if you're able to get 4 minions, and Haunted Creeper gives you that chance.
I mean, Gormok could potentially help him get some extra burst damage in the future as well. If he goes for like a 9 mana Leeroy Gormok, that could pose as a lethal threat as well. I like him clearing up this Imp Gang boss here because the Spider does clear the 2 tokens on its own. So, very good play from Oskaka so far. You know, definitely going for the board-centric line, not being too aggressive at this point, and forcing Pavel to kind of fight back.
Yeah, this is something I was really waiting for, because I always love to watch Oskaka play Zoo. He makes some plays that are not really easy to see, and he has a different style, and he wins with it. Right now, he is a bit behind, unfortunately for him, because of that Knife Juggler, and Golshire Footman, you'll not be able to get into it, but he can slam Lotha, being the biggest minion on board.
So anything else he could do? I think Lothar's probably it here. Plays around Power Overwhelming, one of these small guys. So the 5-5 will need an honest response from the board. And but, you know, Pavel's looking pretty good now. He gets another taunt minion. lots of little taunts. It's very it's not very often you see this. Decides to go for the tap, just using that opportunity while he has board to maybe pick up some extra minions, but finds an Implosion, which is a great card as well. So things are looking pretty good for Pavel at the moment.
Yeah, Oskaka would need something like an Implosion himself to be able to come back from this. Lothab is not doing anything. Just playing Gormok as a body might be something he has to do. Sea Giant, not this turn yet. So with the Power Overwhelming, he can lose the big minions. And then Pavel can slam his own Lothab to block things. So I would not hate something like PO on... Actually, even Implosion, maybe, because he has the Imp Knife Juggler.
I think you need to clear the Imp Gang boss first if you go for the Implosion. You don't want that guy spawning loads of 1-1s. And if he gets a nice number here, 2 isn't brilliant. And, oh, they... 1... Oh, that's awkward.
Yeah, he can still hit the knife, though.
And he clears it. So not too awkward after all. Pavel taking the dominating lead on board here. And this is what you need to do in this Zoo game, and nothing in Oskaka's hand that can help him at the moment.
Yeah, I can't see anything, actually. Just slamming the Sea Giant might be the thing you need to do, and you can't even tap, you're too low at the moment. And there's 5, plus 3, plus 2 more. It's 8, 10, 14 damage. If the knives hit, you will be probably one off still, but that's the position you want to be in anyway.
I don't think there's any way Oskaka has come back from this.
Yeah, especially with Lothab.
Yep, Lothab blocks out any kind of overwhelmings, any implosions. 5 health left, a giant ball from Pavel. This looks like it's probably going to go to a game number 5 to decide who is the champion of the Hearthstone Champions League Season 2. So this is the intense game that you guys want. One of these guys is going to be very happy with the $5,000 and the championship under their belt. And one guy's going to get $3,500, which is not bad at all. But these guys want to win.
I was waiting for you to say, and one of those guys is going to be really unhappy with $3,500.
I mean, I think I would be unhappy as a player in these guys' position. They want to win. I mean, money's great, but you know, tournament wins is what makes you get invites to these invitationals and stuff like that. That's what people look at, so... I mean, money's great, but when you're a competitive Hearthstone player, tournament wins.
The pride
is what. It's the grand prize, really. Oskaka, you know, won a lot of money from the World Championship, but he is the World Champion. That is a title that only him and Firebat hold. I mean,
absolutely.
You know, these titles mean a lot.
But this matchup was supposed to be good for Zoo, and it is a great matchup for Zoo, but Pavel got a very important Wild Grove, and he has a very important Keeper of the Grove into Lothab, or another Keeper if he wants to. So normally, Zoo is able to overpower Druid easily with cards like Power Overwhelming and then the Rubian Eggs. But thanks to the good opening, Pavel has a chance to fight back and maybe even take this game from Ostkaka.
Yeah, those keepers are great. And there's an enhancer Makana, which we were talking about earlier. So he is running the Chinese zoo, the Sea Giant Zoo lot with Leroy completely, those enhancers. But like you said, Pavel has an opportunity to definitely fight on board here. Needs a good implosion, gets a two. Very unfortunate for Ostkaka there.
Yeah, and it was really important because of enhancer Makana as well. If you will get something like a four, he will get a lot of really good imps. Pavel doesn't have a swipe.
And Lofeb is going to lock out any power overwhelming shenanigans coming from these 1-1s. And if he gets a swipe next turn, things will look fantastic for Pavel.
What can Ostkaka do? Just play small minions, I guess. Before you play Enhancer Makano, you want to have as many minions as possible. So he can go for the Flame Imp, Nerubin Egg. Abusive, and even kill the Lofeb, I feel.
Yeah, I think you kill Lofeb at this point. You do clear all your little 1-1s, but if a swipe comes down, it's pretty devastating. So, yeah, I think I like maybe the Imp. You could go for the Egg, but I think the Peddler probably has a lot more value. See what you get from the Peddler first, and might influence how you play the rest of this turn.
Actually,
Seeker, okay.
There is a second abusive which probably changed his line of play, but there was some value in not killing Lothab overall, because Voidwalker is blocking the Lothab unless there is a shapeshift. And if there is a shapeshift, you know that Druid will only have 4 mana for his disposal, and you've seen one keeper already, so there is a chance that there is nothing to block it. But Force of Nature is a great card to deal with a lot of minions at the same time.
He can also Swipe would have been beautiful, though.
Yeah. Swipe would be the best. Like, Swipe is literally worth $1,500 right now, but
So what would you do here? Is it worth using the Force of Nature on this?
You can Keeper and Shapeshift, like Keeper the 2-1 shape, or actually Keeper the 2-2 and Shapeshift into 1-1, and you have a 2-4 to challenge the rest of the minions on board. I think that's probably the best, but if you go for Force of Nature, you clear 3 minions and have nothing, so I think there is nothing better than Keeper overall.
Yeah, he agrees. Simple ping and hero power to try and relieve some pressure off Pavel here. He still has a lot of good cards going into next turn. Ancient of Lore might find him something like a swipe going forward. Druid of the Claw, nice tanky minion. Ostkaka, on the other hand,
is it still Enhanso?
Is it Enhanso time? I would like to see Flaming Enhanso.
I think it might be. Like, if you get the Taunts or Divine Shields, it will be super annoying for Druids to deal with your board, especially if you have 4 minions with buffs. If you get Wind Fury on the 2-1s, they deal 4 damage suddenly. I mean, they will not be able to kill the 2-4, but you can start pressuring and asking yourself, is there that swipe somewhere or not?
Yeah, I think Enhancer is definitely the play. Like you said, it can create such a nuisance for Pavel, where Enhancer would be a